Welcome back to History with Mr. B. This day in history, 6 years ago, May 22nd, 2017, a suicide bomber detonated an explosion at a Manchester arena in Manchester, England. The attack occurred just moments after American singer Ariana Grande finished performing her final song. The blast killed 22 concertgoers, including children, and injured 116 others. ISIS claimed responsibility for the attack, which was the deadliest act of terrorism in Britain since the 2005 London bombings. The attacker was identified as 22-year-old Salman Abedi, a British citizen of Libyan descent. The attack sparked an outpouring of grief and support from around the world, with vigils held in Manchester and other cities. Ariana Grande suspended her tour and returned to the United States following the attack. The UK government raised the terror threat level to critical in the aftermath of the attack. The attack also led to increased security measures at public events and venues across UK and Europe. The Manchester Arena reopened for events just under 4 months after the attack, with a benefit concert featuring Ariana Grande and other performers. A public inquiry into the attack was launched in 2019 to investigate the circumstances leading up to the bombing. The One Love Manchester benefit concert raised over $17 million for victims and their families. Thank you for watching. I'll see you folks tomorrow. It's History with Mr. B, America's history teacher. Welcome back to History with Mr. B, and it's a true crime kind of day. Bonnie Parker and Clyde Barrow were infamous criminals who gained notoriety during the Great Depression for a string of robberies and murders across several states. They were ambushed by law enforcement officers on May 23, 1934, while driving a stolen Ford V8 near Sallis, Louisiana. The officers, who had been tracking them for months, opened fire on the car, killing both Bonnie and Clyde instantly. Bonnie and Clyde were both in their mid-20s at the time of their deaths, and they had become symbols of rebellion and outlaw culture in the popular imagination. The incident became subject of many books, films, and songs over the years, cementing Bonnie and Clyde's place in American folklore. Some people viewed them as romanticized anti-heroes, while others saw them as ruthless criminals who deserved their fate. The Bonnie and Clyde story continues to captivate people's imaginations to this day. Bonnie and Clyde were portrayed on the big screen by Faye Dunaway and Warren Beatty in the 1967 film Bonnie and Clyde. The movie was controversial at its time for its violence and sexual content, but it has since become a classic of American cinema. The true story of Bonnie and Clyde is much more brutal and tragic than the glamorous Hollywood version. Nevertheless, their legend lives on, inspiring countless books, movies, and TV shows. Thank you for stopping in with History with Mr. B, and I'll see you folks tomorrow. Welcome back to History with Mr. B. This day in history, May 24th, 1883, the Brooklyn Bridge opens. After 14 years of construction, becoming the world's largest suspension bridge and linking Brooklyn and Manhattan for the first time. The bridge, designed by John A. Roebling, was a major engineering feat spanning 1,595 feet and standing 276 feet above the East River. Thousands of people gathered to cross the bridge on its opening day, including President Chester A. Arthur. The bridge's construction was not without tragedy. Roebling himself died from injuries sustained during its early construction, and his son, Washington Roebling, became paralyzed while overseeing the project. Despite setbacks, the bridge remained a symbol of American engineering and progress, and it quickly became a popular tourist attraction. Today, the Brooklyn Bridge is recognized as a National Historic Landmark and a beloved symbol of New York City. Why was the Brooklyn Bridge always so tired? Because it was the suspension bridge. After 14 years of construction, the Brooklyn Bridge officially opened to the public. And I already covered all this. This is a repeat. Okay, I'm done. Welcome back to History with Mr. B. May 25th, 1787, 55 state delegates gathered in Philadelphia to draft a new U.S. Constitution, replacing the Articles of Confederation. The delegates included notable figures such as George Washington, James Madison, and Benjamin Franklin. They met in secret at Independence Hall with all the windows and doors closed to prevent eavesdropping. Over the course of the 4 months, the delegates debated and compromised on various issues such as representation, taxation, and the powers of the federal government. The resulting document, the U.S. Constitution, was signed on September 17th, 1787. It established a system of checks and balances among the three branches of government, guaranteed basic rights to citizens. The Constitution went into effect in 1789 after being ratified by 9 of the 13 states. It has since been amended 27 times, including the addition of the Bill of Rights in 1791. The Constitution is the oldest and shortest written constitution of any major government in the world, and it has served as a model for democratic governments around the world. Today, the Constitution remains a cornerstone of American democracy and a symbol of the country's founding principles. Why did George Washington wear wooden teeth? Because he couldn't find a dentist in Philadelphia who accepted his insurance. Thanks for watching History with Mr. B. Welcome back to History with Mr. B. May 26th, 1907, John Wayne is born in Winterset, Iowa, as Marion Robert Morrison. His family moves to Glendale, California when he's about 6 years old. As a young man, Wayne works a series of odd jobs, including a prop boy and an extra in Hollywood. He catches his first break in 1930 when he's cast in the film The Big Trowel. Wayne becomes a leading man in the 1940s, starring in films like Stagecoach and The Long Voyage Home. He goes on to become one of Hollywood's biggest stars, known for his rugged good looks and tough guy roles. John Wayne wins his first Academy Award for Best Actor for his role in a 1969 film, True Grit. Throughout his career, Wayne appeared in more than 170 films and worked with some of the biggest names in Hollywood. He also becomes an outspoken conservative and supporter of the Vietnam War, which earned him both fans and critics. John Wayne dies of stomach cancer on June 11, 1979, at the age of 72. He's remembered as an iconic figure of American cinema and the symbol of rugged individualism in the American West. Thanks for popping in. It's History with Mr. B. I'm your top B and America's history teacher. Thank you.
Hee!